God. Amen.
Today we are going to look on the sovereignty of God.
Amen.
That's one of the seven attributes of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's a series in To Know God mm-hmm. in a Deeper Measure. Psalm 19. Lord reigneth. Let the earth rejoice. Let the multitudes of isles be glad together. Clouds and darkness are round about him. Righteousness and judgment are the habitation of his throne. A fire goeth before him and burneth up his enemies round about. His lightnings enlighten the world. The earth saw and trembled. The hills melted like wax at the presence of the Lord, at the presence of the Lord of the whole earth. The heavens declare his righteousness, and all the people see his glory. Confounded be all they that serve graven images, that boast themselves of idols. Worship him, all ye gods. Zion heard and was glad, and the daughters of Judah rejoiced because of thy judgments, O Lord. For thou, Lord, art high above all the earth. Thou art exalted far above all gods. He that loveth the Lord hate evil. He preserveth the souls of his saints. He delivered them out of the hand of the wicked. Light is sown for the righteous, and gladness for the upright in heart. Rejoice in the Lord your righteous, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holiness.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mm.
Thank you.
One of the greatest attributes of God is his sovereignty. Sovereign Lord. We need to know his sovereignty. It means that he's a ruler. He's in control. By knowing, it's not just an intellectual knowledge of God at all. But to have a heart knowledge that God is sovereign. That he rules your heart.
Amen.
He rules your life. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
So, and the way that we live, we need to show God's sovereignty in our life. Because if he is sovereign in your life, you're going to have an effect on people.
Yes, amen.
They're either going to hate you or they're going to love you. And people will know. If he's sovereign in you, in your heart, it'll be shown to the heathen.
Yes.
That's the word of God says. He's called you for a purpose.
Jesus.
And that purpose is to glorify.